everyone has to perform a dance from their country and the name. So when you enter the stage, that you start dancing your name so that people know who you are. Yeah. And then afterwards you would need to perform your national dance.
Zürich ist der härteste, der dort abgefahren ist, vom USZ bis zum ersten Vorstand.
I'm not going to say much about the Club of Rome. I think you are a little bit familiar with who we are and what we do. If you have questions about our work, I will be very happy to answer them. Just briefly, you can think of the Club of Rome as a think tank, an international think tank, that is dealing with questions of how the planet and humanity in the future might look like and try to identify solutions for the greatest challenges that we will face in 40, 50 years. When we presented the project to possible partners, they were very, very pleased to hear that we were bringing international people here, young people, who would take their own perspective on the city.
Winterthur is known as it's the second biggest city in the county of Zurich, and it's the sixth largest city of Switzerland. We have about now 108,000 inhabitants.
A home is a bag, they give us only one book.
Der Mensch hat ein großes Problem. And people, you have a big...
Generally, I would say even up to as things stand, one is able to say what is really the religious identity of the people of Winterthur, of course, in the bigger context of Switzerland. But particularly Winterthur, the diversity that is there, the collaboration that is there, the peace that is there, the order. I met some foreigners too, like refugees from Eritrea. He was very pleased to be here in Winterthur, actually said he would wish to stay here forever.
I have learned a lot of good things from European or other from Swiss people. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Then I want to apply it in Africa or in Eritrea.
That's beautiful. Actually.
Hello, I'm Marine from Berlin. And I'm working in the field of education and curating exhibitions in several museums. So I'm more or less interested in the history, but not only in certain times of the history, but also in how people see their past. I want to make people choose places, special places for them. That could be the place where they kissed for the first time. That could be a place which is in their everyday life. So, and at the end, I want to make like a collage, like a photo film. So you can see the pictures and the interviews and the sounds of the places all at once.
Good morning, everyone. I am Mark Matthew, but my friends call me Marcus. So I am a disability advocate. Personally, I'm a person with disability. I was born with mild cerebral palsy. I'm from the Philippines. And I'm now working with Leonard Cheshire Disability Philippines, a UK-based NGO working towards disability movement, protection, and promotion of the rights of people with disabilities. So I came here to share perspectives regarding disability. So I'm going to meet some people with disabilities from Winterthur and share our experiences, challenges, and wishes.
Just, Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Have a nice day.
Bye. Bye, honey. I want to work with maybe clichés or words that we can actually define. Compare the same words or adjectives from the foreigner side and from their locals. And make videos, animated videos, with these words. To place a box in a place, in a square or something, and people can put papers, you know, like maybe put a phrase like living in Winterthur is, and people would put some words.
15 years ago, there was a voting in Winterthur because they are missing a lake. Many people in Winterthur are missing a lake, really, yeah. The water is not here, yeah. So then I collect signs. And I had a project for a lake. a real one, also quite realistic.
Mm-hmm.
And then was a voting, but the voting was negative, so they don't have a lake now. Yeah.
And how have you seen the city itself has been changing quite a lot? To a, like from a big industrial town to the modern city, and now Zurich has come up, and people don't know Winterthur.
Yeah, when I was very young man, there was this Sulzer who was so many employees there, and did the machines, like big engines for ships and so. And so the whole city was working there, and it was a working city. And then this all was closed, and now it's, also it changed also in the good, it is much more open. It's not, it was so serious. There was no street cafes. It was not allowed to put the table on the street. And then it was, restaurants were closed on 11. Because the Sulzer said, you should not drink beer all night, you should go to bed. And so, yeah, and now it is much more light and open, yeah. Change to the better.
It's a Protestant church?
No, Catholic one.
There was a lady who told me that she's in charge of this Ulrich, theologian or something. She speaks Swahili.
Really?
Mimi.
Look, we speak Swahili.
To me, so, Nana.
The building was finished in 71, so we have 43 years. And just a year ago, we had to restore everything. And now, since February, we have this cross. Because we thought it is important, nowadays, it is important to show who we are.
The church I went to yesterday was so clean, cleaner than here. There's nothing. It was so white. I was asking, where are these images that I'm used to? Even in Africa, we have a few of them. So they told me here is a place where even the Muslims can pray. Because the Muslims, when they come to a church, the first thing they want to do away with is any image in the church. Because they interpret it to be idol worship.
It has a spirituality, I would say, this church. It is very clear, the lines are very clear.
Feel peace here.
Peter, come on.
Hello. Charles.
He is the president of the parish council.
And I met a Vietnamese also. Vietnam, someone who has stayed here for a long, long, long time. According to him, the church is not in the structure called the church there. His church, the first church's home, actually was interesting. He was saying that he doesn't have to go to church sometimes. In Africa, we walk a long distance, like my home to the church where I went, where I go, is like 7 kilometers. So, according to him, I think the aspect he was bringing that it is not so much going to the church, which is okay, but it is how that going to the church influences your life, in your family. And he's even the president of he's a top leader there, a foreigner, getting that position, which is elective. I think it is something positive for any society.
Für uns ist auch die Familie die Hauskirche. Das ist wenn wir hier am Sonntag frühstücken und es läutet aber die Kirche da drüben am Sonntag, ist ja eigentlich Sonntagspflicht, aber wir finden, dass wir hier den lieben Gott ebenso erfahren, wenn wir da zusammensitzen und es schön haben. Da müssen wir jetzt nicht der Form halber dann rüberspringen und hetzen und ja. Also es ist für uns auch hier Kirche und Gottesdienst. So.
Tschüss.
I'm from India and I'm based in Germany nowadays. I'm doing my PhD research over there. I'm a town planner and urban sociologist by training, and my research mostly revolves around the idea of quality of life and happiness as a citizen of a place. What I'm covering here is City of Winterthur itself. So the basic idea is, what does it mean to be from Winterthur? There are three spheres of the work that I'm planning to do. One is the city itself, second is society, and third is the person or people. So city, maybe we can try to analyze it from the design and development and policy perspective. For that matter, I mean, Daniel and Sebastian have been very helpful to organize some meetings with city officials. We would see how the city plan itself to grow in times to come. From society, my idea is to study a bit of lifestyle. And finally, from people, I would try to see what is their idea of being happy or their overall well-being.
Mein Name ist Jonas Pfister, Bauingenieur von Beruf, komme ursprünglich von Bern, nähe Bern. Bin aus Studiengründen nach Winterthur gekommen und bin fertig mit dem Studium, bin aber geblieben hängen. Ich hatte nie zu reissen für zurück, weil Winterthur bietet mir eigentlich alles, was ich gerne hätte, was ich brauche, was ich will. Also obligatorisch und fakultativ ist für mich hier einfach alles drin. Und darum kein Grund zum Weggehen hier. Einmal ist Winter, immer Winter. Diesen Satz gehört man schliessen häufig.
I'm from Shanghai. But right now I'm working in Norway, Oslo, and I do education programming in a private university in Oslo. My mission is about leisure activity, but to be honest, I'm not a leisure person. I love working. So I will try, because leisure industry, it's a way to to measure how city developed. What I'm trying to do, actually, I'm trying to seeking for a sustainable city, like how to put these 10 days, I'm going to stay here for 10 days, how to use these 10 days to develop something can last in the future.
That's one.
We have a lot of sports facilities. We have an ice sports stadium. It's for ice hockey and figure skating. That's nearby. We have three fields.
Yeah.
We have that's in this building.
Yes.
We have an indoor
swimming pool,
yeah. And the whole city we have five outdoor swimming pools.
Trabajo en el área en el restaurante que se llama taller de investigación. Lo que hacemos es viajar por la Amazonía, ¿sí? Trayendo productos para trabajarlos en el restaurante. Mi idea, en realidad, del proyecto era traer un poco de productos, involucrarme con el concepto de la comida actual en Suiza y un poco enlazar el trabajo que nosotros hacemos de la sostenibilidad del producto, del trabajo con comunidades nativas, con la cultura gastronómica suiza y dejar un trabajo en recetas y combinar un poco los productos.
Nice group of friends who's going to sing for us. Action!
Today is
going. Hi, my name is Nicola. He's Marco. We're from Italy. We have a YouTube channel where we do social experiments with people.
And we have been invited here to Winterthur by the Club of Rome to shoot some pranks, some jokes with a hidden camera in our style.
The videos we've been shooting here so far, most of them are about social media. One of us holding a poster in the middle of a street. On the poster it's written, "I don't have Facebook, do you want to be my friend?"
Encantado, Marco.
No Facebook, nada.
What's your name?
Good accent, Fabian.
Fabian?
Fabian, yes.
Fabian, are you from here?
Yes.
I'm Marco, nice to meet you.
Ah, nice to meet you.
We've been clapperboarding people. With a clapperboard, like in the movies.
Nice group of friends who is going to sing for us. And action! Very beautiful couple who is going to kiss. And action! Nice people who are going to speak Italian. And action!
Now I'm really full.
Uh-huh. It's very good. It's very tasty, and it's has like the flavor of smoke. It's very similar to like a whiskey.
My name is Mahalet, but the short form of that is Millie. I was born in Ethiopia, but I grew up in England and mostly in London, and I'm an academic philosopher. So I'm interested in marginal communities. There's a quote, something like, "Oh, you can judge a society by how it treats its most vulnerable members, or by how it treats its weakest members, or by how it treats its prisoners." There's different versions of the quote. But the idea is that they're hidden communities, and they tell the truth about the society you're looking at, not the official version. So the three philosophers that I'm using are, or thinkers are, Freud, the psychoanalyst, and his idea of the unconscious. So you've got the human mind, and the top bit, there's a small part of it's rational, that's the part that you show people. But most of the mind is unconscious. It's the stuff that you don't, maybe you may not be aware of, or you may not acknowledge because it's maybe confusing or shameful or frightening to you. So maybe some of our emotions, some of our urges, or some of our secrets are in the unconscious. Foucault, the French social theorist, he had this concept of biopower. He saw in the modern capitalist age, society, citizens are like biological parts of the industrial machine. Your job is to be part of the economic machine and produce and consume. I call that biopower, like turning citizens into part of the industrial factory of a country. But you can't control people like that. It doesn't work, and you've got to accept the variety. So I also want to look at the transgressive and the things, parts of Winterthur society that don't quite fit the official narrative. And finally, Paulo Freire, the Brazilian educationalist, he saw education or practice of education as equal exchange. And if the teacher assumes that the student is their equal, then the teacher can learn from the student. So if you assume that people are equal, that their differences are not weakness but just difference, then you can learn from people who are not necessarily as powerful as you. Mainstream society claims to be non-judgmental and tolerant, but we're not, you know. And it's in the kind of actually subversive, hidden communities that you see real freedom. So I want to meet people in marginalised communities and learn from them, and also find out sort of the truth about Winterthur. You can learn from the things that are hidden and that are not acknowledged. I think that's really and positive, constructive, creative things.
Hello, my name is Felix. I come from Cologne in Germany. I study political science in Konstanz, and I'm here as a photographer to accompany the project of the Club of Rome. Here in Winterthur, I'm basically working on two different projects. The first project is to portrait all the other members of the group. I want to take a picture of each participant and like try to reflect their work in their portrait. My second project has a bit of different approach. Actually, I took pictures that I already took in different countries while I was traveling, for example in Morocco, in Iran, or like also pictures I took in Germany. And my idea is to take these pictures and the settings of the pictures and look for these settings again here in Winterthur, just to compare the two perspectives.
You have the alternative scene in Winterthur, which I belong to, with the clubs, concert clubs and things, but you don't have things like, I don't know what you have in other cities, like a gay scene or something. Most of my gay friends, for example, move to Zurich, or at least just go there for going out, because Winterthur, we are the sixth largest city of Switzerland, yes. But we have just one center, we have just other cities in this dimension, they have like two or three centers, and you have different things to experience, and in Winterthur it just doesn't happen. If the city grows more, then it will change, of course.
Yes.
But so far there's not much movement.
Wir sind eine Organisation, die im Auftrag der Arbeitslosenversicherung, im Auftrag der Sozialhilfe und im Auftrag der Invalidenversicherung erbringen wir Leistungen. Also, und wir sammeln Daten über diejenigen Personen, mit denen wir zu tun haben.
Do you have any data to hand? So partly what are the headline figures, but also what kind of data do you collect? So I guess long-term unemployment rates, short-term unemployment rates, and which communities are affected? Because I know in Britain that unemployment affects some groups disproportionately than others.
Yeah, that is not good. Alle, die Daten sammeln, die wissen genau, dass man muss hinter die Daten schauen, wenn man wissen will, was sie genau sagen.
Of course, you could feel the crash. So how did he feel it? What did he feel? What did he notice that was different?
Also, dass zum Beispiel die Zahl der Personen, die sich auf den regionalen Arbeitsvermittlungszentren, diese Jobcenters gemeldet, diese Zahlen steigen. Mhm. Jede Person hat Anrecht auf eine minimale Existenzsicherung. Mhm. Das ist jetzt aber noch behaftet mit einem negativen Touch. Jemand, der nicht arbeitet, der nicht in der Lage ist zu arbeiten, der zu faul ist zum Arbeiten, der muss Sozialhilfe beziehen. Es ist nicht ein positiv besetzter Anspruch.
Yes, this week I've been collecting words. I've done some boxes and placed them in places in the city, in the old town, to ask people what do they think, what do they feel about living in Winterthur. So ask them to write down one word and put it inside a box.
Good luck.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Have fun speaking to the people.
Yes, yeah,
thank you. They once did a survey and they found out that in Winterthur, there are the happiest women from all of Switzerland.
Nice.
So, I'm one of them.
Nice. Hello.
But for the last 12 years, it was never changed.
So it hasn't gone up with inflation?
No, it didn't.
Okay, set with reference. Please, can you tell me a bit about the decision to not change the amount? What happened in the last 12 years that meant the amount was kept?
I mean, constant? We have now in the newspaper and the public is a big discussion about social welfare. They call it, some politicians call us a social welfare industry because we are generating jobs for ourselves to help. Like Christoph Pohl, he has now a big team with 80 people trying to integrate people on social welfare. And we have now, well, if you want to know it, we have now, only the city of Winterthur pays now 100 million Swiss francs every year for the social security. This, in the last 10 years, it went up 60%.
No preciso para hacer el guiso de quinoa.
And now it's late.
For how many people are you cooking? What is your number?
I don't know. How many people come today?
You know, it will be more like tasting menus.
Spanish?
La concorrenza.
In Winterthur war das natürlich auch so, das war einer der größten Arbeitgeber. Also noch in den 70er Jahren hat Sulzer in Winterthur etwa 14.000 Arbeitsplätze gehabt. Heute sind es noch etwa 600, 800. Und das hat natürlich sehr viel dann mit der Veränderung dieser Stadt zu tun. Und mein Lieblingsplatz ist das hier, weil es hier alles noch daran erinnert, wie es einmal war und trotzdem so viele neue Nutzungen möglich waren. Und ich meine, dass das ein außergewöhnlicher Weg war, wie Winterthur zu dieser Kombination kam von auf der einen Seite Geschichte ablesbar, hier industrielle Vergangenheit und auf der anderen Seite modernste Bauten, die Neues beherbergen.
Sí. Desde el 2010, de la primavera del 2010 llegué y vivo aquí en Winterthur desde ese tiempo. Es el hecho de, es normal tener un trabajo, tener las cosas, eso es normal, eso lo tenemos que tener, un seguro para esto, aquello, eso es normal. Si te quedas sin trabajo, sin la salud, si, ¿me entiendes? Y eso no tiene nada malo, porque eso es lo que conocen, lo que tienen y lo pueden sostener así.
Sí.
Lo que me parece triste o para me pone a pensar es el hecho de que creas que así es en todo el mundo.
Ah, sí, es verdad.
Y de verdad he conocido personas que no conocen otra realidad. Y eso me hace como, uy, en el mundo no es así. La otra realidad es muy diferente.
Sí.
Y por eso me siento agradecida de lo que viví.
de donde vengo.
Claro, yo también. Sí.
De que pude ver la, la precariedad y cómo de felices con lo poco.
Sí.
Y eso te permite no deslumbrarte por lo que hay acá. Sí. Es igual lo que tienes. Es...
No, it's not the same.
Even this one is not. Next week I'll be working with kids from the International School of Winterthur. I'll be making some workshops and to illustrate words also, these cliches.
So yeah, we're going to the Michael Schule. It's a school for children with learning disabilities.
Yeah, it's a very, very small group. It has become questioned, you know, because then they're not in the main class in the main school, because we have then segregation within the school. We have children that aren't even integrated fully in the classes. But if you have a child who's screaming all day, it's very difficult to have them in a class.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, some parents will push. It's more, sometimes I have to say, look, it's not going to, you know, be careful. One of the things we don't really want to happen is that a child gets sent to a school and after three or four months is back here because it just doesn't work. And then everyone feels it's a complete failure.
Yeah.
And then the next time that's going to happen, this teacher's going to may well be, I don't want I can't cope with this. This is just crazy. It has to be really step by step. Sometimes a partial integration in the beginning.
Yeah,
be maybe just one afternoon a week. It's a system. You have to question: Are they at home? And it's for the parents. It's difficult when they were in a school where they were staying. You can have far more control over the rhythm. You know, the going to bed, getting up. You see the child for much longer. You get to see who they are.
Amazing dish, take three, action!
Bueno, este plato se llama del bosque suizo a la Amazonía peruana. Paseando por el mercado encontramos unas setas que son silvestres, que vienen del bosque. Tenemos un poco de portobelos y estas castañas que se consumen mucho aquí. Entonces yo he traído esto de Perú, ¿sí? Esto es chonta. Es el corazón de una palmera. Entonces lo que voy a hacer es pelarlo. Yo les voy a enseñar. Yo ya lo tengo avanzado, pero ¿sí? Esto se abre así. Puntualizar que esta palmera es renovable, ¿sí? No, no es que se tumbe una palmera y...
Un poco de vinagre de...
¿Vinagre de?
Vinagre de...
De frambuesa.
Bravo. So in regard of accessibility, like with the wheelchair, I'm so interested in seeing how accessible it really is. Because everybody says like, oh, it needs to be accessible and everybody tries to do best, but I think it's still very hard. Can I go for a ride?
Sure.
Yeah.
The thing is, what I underestimated to go straight.
Yeah.
Barely impossible. I always had to break here and then exactly. It's like so exhausting here.
I'm hoping that I could learn something from them and also them, that they could learn something from me. It's really great to be here. Learning and studying, just immersing with the city, embracing the city of Winterthur.
Thank you very much. I'm really happy to work in this project and I hope the output will be great and we'll have a lot of fun on December 11th.
We really had a great time all together and I'm sure the work we have done together would be something that people in Winterthur would find useful and entertaining as well. So thanks a lot Winterthur and thanks a lot Club of Rome.
For me it was a very interesting project and I really enjoyed working here in Winterthur. I really hope you like the pictures and enjoy them.
Always history is to teach us something, and the history of 750 years is really, really wealthy. There's a lot of rich values that we can learn from history in order to go ahead in terms of developing our future policies. Of course, in view of a globalized world, because we can no longer think in terms of just Winterthur. It is important that Winterthur also comes out to meet the rest of the world.
philosophy began with the ancient Greeks in the marketplace, with Socrates standing in the town square asking questions, and Heraclitus speaking in riddles, and Diogenes doing stunts to make people notice the point that he was making. So I wanted to do that as well with philosophy. I wanted to do public philosophy where I ask ordinary people philosophical questions and use these questions to get them thinking philosophically about their lives. So I came up with these 10 questions and I have been asking people. So I'd like to give those 10 questions to the town of Winterthur that you can keep asking yourself, maybe every few months, every year, every time you have to make a difficult decision. Ask yourself these 10 questions and see what you find. And I hope that will be helpful to you. Thank you.